to the Bear Bryant Show. We're glad you could join our review of the exciting action of the University of Alabama Crimson Tide football. The Bear Bryant Show is brought to you by your local Coca-Cola bottler. Coke is it. Golden Flake snacks, good as gold. And your local Carathon dealer. We bring comfort to inner space. Now let's take a look at this week's game. Alabama versus Mississippi State. Comments by Coach Paul Bear Bryant and me, Stedman Shuler.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome once again to the Bear Bryant Show, which is brought to you by Ice Cold Coca-Cola, the local dealers across the state of the Carasan Heater, and our good friends from Golden Flake. And today, Coach, we've got sour cream and onion potato chips.
And it almost didn't taste very well. You know, Mississippi is a great state, and they have a lot of wonderful people over there, and we love them very much, but I'm glad we don't have to go back to Jackson anymore this year. So we've had a couple of trips over there, and one yesterday was pretty nerve-wracking, I'll tell you, because the clock time ran out. I don't know if it ran out on, but it ran out. And I was proud of our team, of course, for winning, and I thought we played pretty hard. On the other hand, first of all, I made three decisions I know hurt us. And two of them was based on personnel and thinking they'd have a championship team. The other one was misunderstanding. The first one was we kicked a field goal into the wind, so it was about 40 yards. And I said the kicking team, I meant the punting team, and they went to the field goal, and I let them go along with that. And then twice on fourth down, well, we went more than twice, but twice we went on fourth down and didn't make it. And the last time, we had about a yard to go on the 14-yard line. And I say again today, I'd do that again for this reason. If we're a championship-caliber team, if our people really want to win as bad as I think they did, we'd have made it, and we made it easy. But the times we did make it, we went forward, our line penetrated, and the time we didn't, our line they penetrated on us. And my thinking down there on the 14-yard line, the time again, if we make it, well, we may not score here even then. But still, we're going to be taking out some time every time we put the ball in play. If we kick a field goal, we may not make it. But if we do make it, we got to kick off to them and then run it back for a touchdown, onside kick, so on and so forth. But the big thing is, and I think a championship, and I think we had a bunch of guys that would make a yard. If you can't make a yard, why, you're not putting much into it. And Mississippi State didn't let us. And Mississippi State has a good football team. And that Bond is everything you've ever heard about him being. He doesn't drop very deep. He stays close to the line most of the time, and he can get rid of that ball most any direction. And when he's running the option, normally he's going to pitch the ball. And he can get rid of it, he deals it. He's just phenomenal. And they had a good football team, and the big hit, number eight, that I was so frightened about, didn't hurt us all that much, but they made some outstanding catches. They made us tackle a lot in the open field, and it takes a good football player to tackle in the open field. But we did get a few rushes on him, and particularly King has some good rushes on him, and we had some big plays. But it looked like every time we fixed to put them away. And something would happen, they'd come right back. And when they got the ball the fourth quarter, the last time they had the ball, they were really going strong. And you'll see some plays in there. The great Ricky Moore one. He ran over a couple, looked like a big bull running down through there. If you run like that every time, start like that every time, he hurt people. And Turner did the same thing once. He just went down through there and buzzed a couple of them and kept on going. But we don't get enough of that. But I'm real proud of them for winning. I think one thing about it, our preparation was really handicapped out of there. Walter Lewis, Wilcox, and B.D. Jackson, Rue, Simons, Smith Ryder, Colbert had knee surgery last week. Paul Fields, Weiss, Klein, and Colburn all during the week. Klein was injured. And in the game yesterday, we had Wilcox got hurt in the first half, and then Colbert was left over for observation, hasn't been hit in the head, and he's all right, though, because I talked with the doctor about 9 o'clock last night. He's going to call back if he wasn't. And Klein was hurt, and he went back in, had a real big play after he went in there. And we don't know how we'll be this week, but Wilcox, as a matter of fact, graded 100% before he was injured. He was injured in the second quarter. So we didn't have a real good week of preparation, and we have a big game coming up this week, so hopefully we can do better, but I don't know. A lot of those people we didn't play yesterday that were injured, and maybe they'll be able to play next week, but we'll get into that step and go ahead and get something going, old boy.
Okay. We'll be back for the first quarter following this important message from our sponsors.
Okay, kids, take a break.
Cooking food, the most refreshing way to make the most of every day. And wherever you go and whatever you do, there's something big waiting for me and you. Cook is it,
the biggest taste you've ever found.
Cook is it, the one that never lets you down. Cook is it, the most refreshing taste around.
Inner space. That's right.
Inner space. Lower your thermostat and save money. The cold dampness of outer space can make it unlivable. Discover an amazing way to heat a room for just pennies an hour. Kerosene portable kerosene heaters. 99.9% fuel efficient, precision designed and safety tested to the highest technical standards. Kerosene brings comfort to inner space for a price that's comfortable too.
Available at Better Merchants. For your nearest dealer, see the yellow pages under Heating Equipment Retail.
You know, I really felt like we were going to win the game here when we lost the toss. We lost the toss, they chose to receive, and we got the win. And, of course, you see where it kicked off there. Bear Sanders kicked it all the way out of the end zone. And then we get the ball in the third quarter to win in the fourth quarter. And I think that might have won the game for us. That was a great play there by
Russ Wood.
Russ Wood. Russ had a couple of three or four big, big plays. One interception was just unbelievable. Mississippi State runs a wishbone. They throw them off of it more than most people. That's why John Bond, they're attacking them. I won't try to identify their people, but Big Mike Pitts had a hold of him. I'll tell you another place that had some big plays, Emmanuel King. They've fair caught the ball. We've fair caught the ball there. Dale White, Walter Lewis back to pass. He goes out of the trap.
One thing about us taking a win, it gave us good field position.
Yeah, and that's Joe Carter. I want to certainly, the Carter family has our deepest sympathy. Joe had a death in his family. And he always starts the other day. And Walter Lewis back running. He has Mickey Moore in there with him, Paul Caruth, and Joe Carter. Paul Caruth running the football there now. Both of those halfbacks are from Mississippi, and they're getting pretty good bedding about it, too, I think. Walter Lewis again, nice block out on the corner there. They got to get him up to shoot.
Thought Ricky's going to score on this play.
Yeah, he looked like he's looking up somebody to run over there. He cut down that sideline, he might have scored. William Moore from Huntsville. He's a sophomore. Walter Lewis is back again. Right to the center. Cat got and kiss him to guard.
That's a flare screen we've used a couple of times this year, and it worked real effectively.
We don't use it enough, so. Doug Vickers, Joe Beasley tackles. Grogan's a tight end. Now, we used to Grogan's tight end. We used to try to tight end, but also use Betsy Bendos over there, Jesse Bendos. Paul Cruz run with the football, tackle here from him, they recover. So we go on and cash that one in. Well, we're in pretty good shape. They run a counter play. You can see if they don't, not very friendly. They run hard. They have some real speed, too. Much to they run out of double wing back here.
Jackie
great
Klein
play.
And company on the tackle.
Jackie Klein, Ryan McCullough. Jackie was injured in the game. I said he went back, and I know he had one big play called the summer. Backed up there pretty well. Got to kick out behind the end. I'm afraid that we'd get a roughing for him. I'm always afraid of that. But Darrell White here. Darrell really got bummed when he hit him. A very nice catch. Catching the ball into him. Good field position now.
Here comes a pass to Joey Jones. Official ruled was out of the end zone.
Beautiful pass. The protection was good. It was a perfectly thrown pass.
That's Sheila.
Lou George caught it. Bless his heart, I wouldn't say he's the best receiver in America right now, I expect. He's not. He's got a teammate. He is. We throw to their man this time, and they take over on the 30-yard line. We didn't get anything again. So here they come now. That's Bond running with the ball.
Jackie Klein again on the tackle.
And Russ Wood puts the wood to him. That's what he wanted. See how Bond deals that ball and runs down that chute? And they have more speed than I really thought they had. Bruce Aaron knew that. He deals the ball off again.
Tommy Wilcox.
Tommy Wilcox. Tommy tackle. Tommy Wilcox of New Orleans. Hand to hand. Bond again deals the ball. He got tackled around his Adam's apple, around the arm.
Mike Pitts from the opposite side.
Ran him down behind that time.
That's the way you stop.
Big, big play right there.
Mike fought off the lead block and made the tackle.
Big play with Mike Pitts. Mike's from Baltimore. You're a senior. He's one of our captains.
It's a play where Tommy, I ain't heard it.
I believe it was, too. This is one of our captains. Ken Coley was one of our captains, and he had a fine game, too. Josh Henderson, Jeff Fagan. Jackie Klein, all captains. Looks back to run, then back to pass. He ran for a few yards outside of the container. So we have to kick. That's not a very good place to be kicking from.
Malcolm Simmons was punting, kicked a 53-yarder. I almost thought he'd out-kick coverage, and Jay Grogan made a great play.
If Jay hadn't made a play, it might have been. See all that ball coming back into the picture?
Rocky Coburn.
Rocky Coburn made the tackle.
On the tackle.
High pursuit is, the effort is good there. They're just a good football team. They're doing things well against us. They're the best team I've ever seen. They lost six games. I tell you, great, great play here. Stick, hold with him, stay with him. That's the King, Emmanuel King. If you get him down there, Emmanuel, maybe Russell covered the ball. Emmanuel makes some things happen, I'll tell you that. He's going to be playing a lot more than he's been playing. He's throwing that one away, I think. Dr. Brocco on the side there. Boy, that is a good blocking on that play. That quarterback can run. End of the first quarter, Alabama zip, Mississippi State zip.
And thus I bequeath my mansion, my automobiles, my stocks and bonds, and all my gold to my third cousin, Angela.
Angela?
Who has always shown exceptionally good taste.
Golden Flake corn chips. The fresh, crisp, golden light taste your family will treasure. Golden Flake. Good as gold.
A part of every day. A part of living life away. On the run, having fun. Always so much to do. Always something big waiting for me and you. Cook is it, the biggest taste you've ever found. Cook is it, the one that never lets you down. Cook is it, the most refreshing taste around. Cook is it, cook is it, cook is it, cook is it.
I want to talk with you about something that's real important to me, and I know it's important to a lot of people out there. And that is young Hank Crisp. Coach Hank Crisp was at the University for many, many years. Everyone loved Coach Hank. I certainly did. He didn't accumulate a lot of wealth or anything like that, but he had more than that because he had so many friends. And he spent most of his money on people like me and others. Anyway, he passed away. He died up here, had a heart attack at the Hall of Fame one year. And Miss Crisp and young Hank is all of the Crisp family that's left. And little Hank has a very terrible disease right now. He's in bad, very bad shape at the hospital. And Miss Crisp is not, she's suffering for funds, frankly. And I want to help start a Hank Chris fund, a little Hank, any way you want to put it. At the First National Bank in Tuscaloosa, and that's easy to remember. George Shirley's going to handle it down there. I'm going to make a contribution in the morning. And if you love Coach Hank like I did, and I think I mean a lot of you do, but you remember just any kind of crisp or Hank, anything, you'll get it. It's in First National Bank in Tuscaloosa. And as I say, they need it, and I think we all want to. I'm real happy that I'm fortunate enough to be able to send something, and I hope you are. And I know all the people that knew Coach Hank and loved him like I did, and Catherine will. Desmond?
Coach, I'd also like to wish Chucky McNeil, who's sick here in the hospital, the best, because he's recently had a serious surgery also.
Well, along with that, I've been meaning to do this 2-3 weeks. Lamar Moy, teammate of mine, one of the Rose Bowl teams, is their sister up here. And certainly hope you're doing well tomorrow, and hope you come out of there soon.
Well, just kind of getting back to football, we looked like we were going to blow them out the first quarter, first two times we get the football, but we turned the ball over and twice, and I think that's what's kind of been plaguing us. That's what's keeping us from maybe really becoming the kind of team that we can become, and the kind of looks like we've got the ability there, but we keep hurting ourselves.
Yeah, we keep talking about having the ability, and I think we have the ability, and with the leadership, I think we have the leadership. We're not tough enough to start with. We don't push ourselves enough, and in the clutch, we don't rise up and give it a little extra. And maybe we'll do that this week. Maybe we won't. If we don't, we're just going to be an ordinary football team. But we have the possibility, I think, of being a great football team, but we can't do it that way. We can't do it talking about it. We have to prepare and during the week and go out and put the show on Saturday. And I think our players know that, and they all talk about how much they want to be in a championship. They want to do that. But that talking is cheap. The place to do it on the football field. So let's get into the second
quarter. Move on into the second quarter.
What's going on. We get a... They're kicking here. Went out of bounds.
Perry could have come into the ball game and almost made something happen.
We have a new line in there, too, now. We have a new team in there, as a matter of fact. Here comes a counterplay. Jeff Fagan runs about 16 or 17 yards on it. He didn't run the thing enough. A couple times a game, we never do. We just start one way and go that way all the time. Great effort down there by somebody. Little Joey Jones. Jeff Fagan from Hollywood, Florida. Jeff and Jesse from the same town. Holcomb is a center now.
Vincent Elder ran with the football then, freshman.
Vincent did pretty well while he was in there. When I saw the film this morning, probably didn't play him enough. Spencer's under the ball, not fake for the ball this time. They came up and stopped us, and we had to kick. So we had Kivak in there, and Bramlett, Oakland, here's Duke. Mississippi State, Henry Ballard, their coach is an excellent coach and a fine person. They come in with the late stuff, back coming out of the backfield that everybody's heard us on. All that does make you make the open field tackle, if you can tackle. But it's not very difficult if you can. Of course, the back coming out of there.
They fumbled football then, and the ball bounced right back to him. Game tackling.
A lot of game grabbing and tackling there in between. See, Bond doesn't take a big drop. That's as far as he ever drops. A lot of times he just drops loose.
He gets rid of the ball in a hurry.
Yeah, a great release.
Difficult to get him down.
The ref forced it to end. The ball went in the end zone. I thought Darrell did a good job of deep corners. So here we go now. Kenny Cole is the quarterback. We're going on a long drive. And I was real happy for Kenny. He's one of our catchers for the game. It was a great, hard luck story. Kenny kept the ball then. The play broke up out there. They had two men outside. He saw he couldn't do it. Couldn't been outside very wisely.
At third and one, and the line came off the ball, and touchdown Turner got the first down.
Line came off the ball real well. That Lenny Patrick running with the ball, and he gets baptized pretty good there. Every time Lenny touches it, they're going to give him pretty good going over. Here comes on the Statue of Liberty play here. And I tell you, they hit.
We didn't fool them too much there,
did we? Well, we got a few yards out of it, but I tell you, Get him back to pass. Now, here's a perfect pass, a beautiful pass, just as someone was knocking his head off. Almost. And Bill Joy Jones. Joe just made a great, great catch there. And their man played it about as well as you could play it.
Kenny comes right back, makes a nice run. Showed some quick feet.
Quick feet, he has. Real fine run, McKinney. Somebody down there stood a blocking, kind of aiming. Didn't get his aim down right. I've actually got up a little close this time. Jeff Fagan running the football and power play. We had somebody get penetration. Kenny Patrick running on the power play there, running hard too. The guy ran through, knocked him down.
Just running straight at him now. Line's coming
up. Look at that line come over. Look at that line blocking there.
That's Vickers.
Doug Vickers. I told Doug I hope he'd play like I expect him to play yesterday. I don't know.
Then you're trying to get everything you can.
They need it all, yeah. Here comes a sweep for Patrick. The fullback missed his block, and two men out there blowing, clamming him down. Didn't get much.
They got a face mask penalty.
That's a big penalty they got there. And touchdown Turner goes in for the touch. Look at how we move them out of here now. Look at this way they come forward here. He turns and he hits up in there.
You come off football like that and you get somebody that can jump, you're not going to be stopped.
You're not going to be stopped with 4th and 1.
We had a good crowd at the game.
Yeah, I was talking to him before the game, and that one corner of Holger snapped it back. Malcolm Simmons held it, and Peter Kim kicked it. I was talking to him before the game. I said, don't worry, we're going to have a sellout. I looked up in that dead corner. He said, well, we sold over 60,000 before yesterday. I think it was a sellout.
We almost get a big play here.
Yeah, I'm glad he bounced it off his chest. He's kicking short there. Bear Sanders is kicking. There's him in Birmingham.
Rocky Coburn comes up and makes the hit.
I say to you, man, let all tackle. That's not a very good recommendation for our linebackers, I'll tell you that.
Emmanuel King on that tackle.
Emmanuel King from Leroy. He's the pride of Dr. DeShazo, M92. Got to play for the ball. Go for the football. We don't do enough work on going for the football when it's in the air. Tackle there.
Eddie Lowe and Russ Wood. Gerald Sprinkle kind of putting a little pad on him. Gerald Sprinkle again.
John Bond. We tried awfully hard to get John Bond. That's a great catch. Real great catch for that man. Knocked out of bounds by Eddie Lowe down there. Another great catch. He reached behind him and caught it one hand like Rick Stevens in the world of baseball when he was in his prime. And he overran it. Rick never overran any of those. So he's just like, here comes Statue of Liberty.
Rocky Culver makes a saving tackle.
That's a real big one. Don't give him too much.
Gerald Sprinkle makes another saving tackle. I think Baum got to the 3-yard line and made him have to kick a field goal.
Well, go over the field goal now. That's a good call on Baum's part. I'm sure they're thinking about the Texas game, too. So they get to make it 7-3.
With the strong
wind. Very nice kickoff.
No way we were going to return a kickoff with the wind.
That's George Jones back there fielding the ball.
Few seconds left.
Now those two plays right there were stupid plays. I lost the ball game and tied another in doing that. I'll tell you about it later. Alabama 7, Mississippi State 3. To half.
Space. Add more to your home, add more to your fuel bill. Lower your thermostat. Watch out. Bitter cold outer space can make inner space unlivable. Solution, a Kerosene monitor system. One of the most efficient heating systems on Earth. Easy to install, thermostatically controlled, with a memory bank that turns itself on and off. A Kerosene monitor system for economical comfort beyond the ordinary.
Available at Better Merchants. For your nearest dealer, see the yellow pages under Heating Equipment Retail.
First you thought all it would take was a pair of gold earrings. That didn't work. Neither did the gold necklace. But then you had the audacity to send me Mold and Flake teeth curls. I'll have you know that I love Gold and Flake teeth curls.
Nobody says no to Golden Flake. It's good as gold.
By the way, what took you so long?
Midway in the second quarter, we have an 80-yard drive, have a big touchdown, but right before the half, Mississippi State comes back and kicks a field goal and almost scores a touchdown, and I believe they did that in the third quarter. They came back after we scored, and looked like we're going to have momentum, and they seemed to shut down on
us. The first quarter, we fouled up, we're not getting something, we didn't get anything. In the first quarter, we were down there twice and didn't get anything, and then you know what happened in the third quarter, and Coley took them all the way for a touchdown and a couple of great plays in that series. Now we'll come back the second half, and the start of the second half is very important. And we're going to have the win, and we should pad it, get enough score on that to kind of pad it in the third quarter. If we don't, we're in bad shape in the fourth quarter. But we did better in the third quarter than we did in the fourth quarter, but we had to win in the fourth quarter. We hadn't had to win by the meet.
People don't realize when you're playing in a foreign territory like playing in Jackson, Mississippi, momentum's such a big thing for
you. See, yeah, when you have them on the ropes like we had them a couple of times, the crowd quiets down. That's one thing that helps you. I mentioned many good players. The last two plays we ran before the half, it was a real bad call, and I made them. But that's ridiculous. When you go run the clock out, the thing you do is to have the quarterback take the ball and put it on the ground and lay on it and let the clock run. And you say, well, that's ridiculous. You ran a safe play. Well, the one time we played in Arkansas and I was A&M, we ran a safe play and he broke loose about 5 yards and started to run with the ball. Sure enough, and it jerked it out of his hand and took the time out, lined up, and threw a pass for touchdown beaters. And one time in Kentucky, playing Tennessee, and did the same thing, ran a handoff sweep, a power play, wasn't going out of bounds. And we found the thing again. So the little time that we had yesterday, I just had the quarterback put the ball on the ground and others stand around him. If that happened, you just have him do that.
Yes, I will. In today's university feature, we'll take a message from the university president, Dr. Joab Thomas, about the University of Alabama Sesquicentennial Capital Campaign.
At the University of Alabama, we work each day toward quality in teaching, research, and service. It is our commitment to the students, to the university, and to our state. But our hard work and commitment are not enough. We also need your commitment. Join Coach Bryant and me to support the Sesquicentennial Capital Campaign.
I want this university to be top-notch in every respect. This university is my alma mater, and I am tremendously proud of that. I think that the students are entitled to the finest professors in the world, and I think the professors are entitled to the greatest bunch of students to teach. And the alumni and friends are entitled to expect a top-notch university in every respect.
Keeping Alabama's first university first is what this campaign is all about. It's a commitment to having the best faculty up there, teaching the best students right here.
That you there pointing to the best students?
I don't know, Coach. Law school is pretty tough on me. I don't think I would be quite the best student.
Well, I'm mighty proud of you being over in law school and doing so well, I'll tell you that. And having enough time to help us, too. So you must be pretty busy.
My wife thinks so.
Have you disciplined lately?
No, sir. I stopped giving Ann discipline early in my marriage. That's for sure. She's kind of keeping straight now.
Well, that's good. She's a wonderful young lady.
We'll be back for the third quarter following this important message from our sponsors.
Refreshing taste around.
outer space. The icy cold that invades your home because you lower your thermostat to save money. Result?
Inner space can become unlivable. Conquer this problem with the Kerosene portable kerosene heater. Precision designed and safety tested to the highest technical standards and 99.9% fuel efficient. 99.9%.
Kerosene brings back comfort to inner space for a price that's down to earth.
Available at Better Merchants. For your nearest dealer, see the yellow pages under Heating Equipment Retail.
We're receiving here, and we have the wind. They're kicking into the wind. I'm not wrong about that. We're receiving. They have the wind. We're going to have the wind in the fourth quarter.
We come out throwing the hitch pattern. We miss our first one, but later on you'll see that we complete several, and I think that was the best thing we did, just throwing the short pass and moving the ball down the field. Because a lot of people give us that short pass on the outside perimeters. Here comes to Jesse Bindros.
Jesse's pretty nifty runner. He can enjoy both after catch football.
Ricky Moore comes right back and makes a nice run.
Fine block. Great block there by Vickers.
I think Vickers must have listened to you, Coach. He's had several real
nice. Well, that man came in there a little late, and the fish is looking right at him. I always brag on the officials.
Run the hitch to the other side, and Joey almost broke it.
He almost broke this one, I'd say.
When you run a 4.440, you can do that.
He almost broke his neck on that line, too. He's a tough little rascal, though. And a fine young man, excellent young man. Talk to this running with football. Real fine running with all year. I certainly hope his mother's feeling better. She will.
We hurt ourselves here with a...
Yeah, we running backwards, going away from the line, pitching the ball. We didn't have a chance. Well, everybody's not going to be perfect. Every player you run is not going to be perfect. Ball is back fast. Nobody blocks the end over there and comes in and be horned. Thankfully, he got rid of the football first, and they didn't catch it. So we go for field goal here, which is unrealistic thinking, kicking the ball that far. I didn't miss it much, but I should have had him punt the football. And now they got good field position, see, as a result of going to that field goal. They have plenty of time to pass. He starts right out, but going for the bomb, and I tell you, that frightened me. I don't think either man saw it back there. Do another Wiley.
That's a big third down play here.
Yeah.
And they actually...
Look at that ball. That felt like a wounded pigeon.
Give them a first
around
down.
And let them catch it. That's the first thing we do is go for football when it's in the air.
Tom McCready on the tackle. Big Tom.
Tom's on the tackle. Tom played a lot. We played Edward Gutt and Guard a lot. I remember this play very well because I already told someone to go and give Tom a rest. He makes a big play and he's already out there. I left him in there longer. But the three men did all the playing there in the middle because Eli couldn't play at all.
Russ Wood put a lot of pressure on the quarterback there, and Eddie Lowe makes the hit.
Russ Wood, Melba, Alabama. He was senior, one of our final leaders. Eddie Lowe is from Phoenix City. Real great decoy in there by Darrell White. He goes in for a touchback, so we got the ball now. Ricky wasn't running like he ran over there when he ran over those people. He's running this time. Trying to run with Lenny Patrick. There wasn't much there, but you get all the crumbs you can get when you can.
This is probably one of the biggest plays of the day. 9, Ricky Moore.
Like this, you want to see something good. Ricky Moore got up some steam out here now. If you run like this every time he touches the football, go ahead there, boy. Right. Okay. I hope you remember that. In first place, he's got to work on his starting. None of our backs do. He gets some speed up like that, big as he is. He punches the field. Watch Turner does the same thing. No, that's Joe Carter carrying the football. I said Joe's at home today.
Here comes a pass to our tight end.
Beautiful play, beautiful play, beautiful catch. Thrown quickly, thrown just right. So the offside back was gotten there. Motion this way for Patrick. Play action pass.
Marcus timing was perfect.
That's slow.
Later been probably incomplete.
Beautiful catch for Jay Logan. Real fine catch. And the protection was excellent on that too. Everything was perfect. Now we have a start of sweep here.
And then he tries to score and just can't get everybody out of his way.
That's a good effort, then. Good effort by a fullback with the trying to knock people down.
They get penetration here, and Turner's not able to.
Yeah, see, the red men, all the way two red men back here in our backfield.
We try it again and get it this time, though.
There's plenty of that. They moved out Joe Beasley, and they went forward then. There they come now. Joe Beasley and Edcock. Steve Mott. Big, big play. Now we go for two here. That makes it 11, I think. And we always go for two with 11. You want to write that down?
I think that's the next time we score.
Oh, the next time, yeah.
Yes, sir.
That's 14-3. Now, we're down from, I think we're going to put the bonnet on them, the dude would say.
And they turn around and have a long drive.
Almost broke a touchdown. He is scared to death, yeah. I think Josh Henderson made the tackle there.
Yes, sir.
Josh Henderson, senior. He was one of our captains yesterday.
Stan Gay and Russ Wood.
That's that young who did so well last year. He didn't have a good day against us this year. Center pulls. Quarterback pull away from the center then. They call the thumb. That's running some time off the clock. Here comes Statue of Liberty play. That was pretty puny dive at him there, but that's not tackle here. It's Stan Gay. Stan Gay's a Tuskegee. Stan Gay's a junior. Oh, my goodness.
Stan Gay has to run him down.
His hand off the fullback, straight through. They'll do that in that situation.
They go for two and try the same play.
Same play again. That was a big, big play there, stopping them. A big, big play.
Walter makes a nice move.
Nice run. Ricky Moore had the end on the ground, though. He was smothering him out there.
Joe Carter running with the football.
Joe Carter, junior from Starkville, Mississippi.
It's done more this time. And
Turner's trying to run. Look at it. That's the way he's supposed to run. But you got to get started before you can do that. That's why it's so important to get started out of those blocks in practice.
Instead of going over the top this time, we went wide on a 31 play.
Nice block out there by, I believe it's Caruth. Anybody that block, he's running over. I'll shake him up. I'll give you a little.
Walter overthrows the hitch a little bit.
That was flanker. Man goes in motion. Joe Carter. Pitch out to Carter. Nice block to the shoot band out there. The wide man, what we call it, is run down the chute between the wide man and the next man on the line of scrimmage. You see the man out there on the block? That's
Jay
Grogan, yeah.
Jay had several nice blocks.
Had a nice block at the line of scrimmage there, too. A nice block down there. We're having all kind of nice blocks on there. 2-on-1.
Ricky Moore made that last block.
But get more of a muscle. Now he's running like he's running 2 miles. No, he's not.
Lenny.
That's good running by Lenny Patrick. Lenny's a junior from Jasper, Alabama.
We're going to see it again. Watch some of Lenny's moves.
That's why with Jay Rogan. Jay must have had a good game. Jackson, Mississippi, a great place to play. If you like to really fumble the football out of bounds then.
Walter comes back here and Joey Jones makes one of the finest catches. You'll see.
Beautiful pass, a perfect pass, and one of a great, great catch. But little Joey Jones, of Mobile, Alabama. I should say Big Joey Jones.
He plays big, doesn't he, Coach?
He sure does.
You'd never know he's 5'9".
Well, Vickers made a good block there, too, again. As a hand, nobody ever touched him. He's in between.
I really had gotten in the wrong covers to run the play, but it worked out.
But he hit and go, wasn't it?
Yes, sir.
They was in the 5. That wasn't good, but still made it good. Great catch with a perfect pass, too, to Walter Lewis. Wallace had beaten Alabama. He was injured and still is. So it's 20-9 now. 11-point lead. We're going for 2.
They blitzed everybody on the play.
It'd have been perfect if we'd had to slow one man down. Well, he'd gotten through his hole there. So he didn't make it. It was a bad call.
They've had 2 nice returns on the kick, getting good field position.
Yeah, well, I tell you, they didn't have one for a touchdown. I'd settle with another time for 30 yards, to the 30-yard line. They stepped out of bounds there. We're trying awfully hard to rush. We get that little pocket, this man coming across. Steve Booker made the tackle there. Steve has good speed. He's run for Alabama. That was another he just dropped. He really can release that football, didn't it, Steve?
Comes a fumble, recovered by Tom McCray.
Real big one, real big one. I think that was Jackie Klein. That was Jackie was injured, too. Touchdown Turner ran with the football. Craig Turner from Baltimore, Maryland.
Kenneth Culley's back in the game.
Have a new line in there now. Joe Disney, Kaviak.
Run a hoopy play here.
Here comes a hoopy pass, and Don Horsted, who normally just turned it on straight ahead, started running sideways. And he didn't get the first down. So in the quarter, Alabama 20, Mississippi State 9.
Know what that reminds me of?
Mm-hmm.
Our first date. You invited me out for a stroll and treated me to a bag of golden flake potato chips.
Oh, yeah. It's nice to know some things are just as good 45 years later.
Fresh as ever, too.
Me?
Try our new no-salt-added potato chips. Same good as gold taste without added salt.
Okay, kids, take a break.
Cookies is the most refreshing way to make the most of every day. And wherever you go and whatever you do, there's something big waiting for me and you. Cookies is
the biggest taste you've ever found.
Cookies is the one that never lets you down. Cookies is the most refreshing taste around.
Coach Bryant, we had a pretty good third quarter. We scored 2 touchdowns, allowed them to score 1. Then we go into the fourth quarter, and it proved to be a barn burner.
Well, I know we played well in the fourth quarter, but of course, going for the field goal, not twice, and not making either one of the first downs, would be a real big plays. And time running out with a big play. But the greatest play of all was Castile making a tackle down on the 6-yard line, not letting him out of bounds, not letting him have the first down, and didn't have enough time for the clock to run out. That happened to us last year against Mississippi Southern, and we called a timeout where they had plenty of time to get the team in and kick a field goal. Of course, it's a long field goal.
People don't realize how hard it is when you're running a 2-minute offense to have everything oriented and to go right. And I know Mississippi State's probably today thinking, I wish we'd put on a pass out of bounds to stop the clock. But I'm glad
that 2 years ago we've done that too.
Of course, we were wishing, weren't we? Golly, were we wishing. We've had 3 years in a row, game to go right down to the wire. Well, let's move on into the fourth quarter. Mickey Ginyard running with football.
I think Ginyard was good back. He was doing real well. He's been injured a lot. At one time this fall, I think Mickey and Horsdale are 2 best halfbacks. Ken Coley running with the football. If he hadn't slipped, he was going a good way to score.
fourth and three.
We're getting good field position here again, but we kicked at it and missed it. We had good field position. A situation like that, with 3 yards to go, it's kind of like going from
Jeremiah Castile defending.
True, you either ought to throw the football or have some kind of option where you do more than one thing. That was well over the throw, and he was probably overthrown. He might have gone over the back quite a bit. You know, when they go in double wing back, they send their fullback through right down the middle every time. That's Young that caught that ball, the one that was such a great
play. So the play to catch you.
Great play, great effort there by Russ Wood. Senior from Elba, Alabama. So we're in good shape down in midfield and we ought to go somewhere. If they have other ideas.
See, they're not giving up.
Well, they're certainly not. Flank it this way, we'll all loose back to pass.
They blitz us.
Yeah, they get us back there for a big loss. So we have to kick now. Well, our good field position didn't do us any good. We took up very little time on the top of that. So now we punt to them. Looks like we're going to run out of the stadium. Somebody's gathering around the ankles.
Clown and Rodriguez making the tackle.
I tell you, old Pitts put a good job on.
I know, as a quarterback, and you get hit every play, it hurts.
Yeah, come on back. Come on, that's the boy. Big Mike Pitts. Real fine job of Mike and Russ Wood. They're sending their fullback down the middle every time.
They have a big third down completion here. Third downs have hurt us all year.
He deals that ball off. Yeah, we've been beaten on third down this year much more than we won on third down. Real fine running there.
Eddie Lowe has to make the tackle.
Eddie Lowe saves it. Their fullback is moving. Ball was in the air. We didn't go very far. We learned the pattern. I think he's still, I think, official.
Edward and Pitt.
Real fine play in there.
Stop by.
Running the clock, too. They're going for a field goal here. And it's good. Makes it 20 to 12. Boy, I'm glad a field goal is all they got out of that drive.
We were a little bit too deep lining up against the wind. Comes a great catch by Joey Jones.
Real great catch. Walter Lewis passes Joey Jones on the outer way on the sideline.
The Mississippi State's tired and we're.
Looks like we're going to move right on through him here. Joe Carter ran with the ball there. Real fine run with Joe Carter. Running over there behind Beasley. And Adcock.
Walter get
everybody out of the way. He may go somewhere there. Everybody looking back at him. Knock somebody down. Real fine running in, too. Excellent running. Walter going for the first down makes it. Looks like we're just going to run right on down there.
We're knocking them out of there. Minnie Patrick running with the football.
We knock them out of there, we'll get fourth down here. That's when we really need it. Let's see how we knock them out. Got Joe Carter by one of his feet then. Big Moore running with the football.
A third and five here. Motion. Run the option. The safety man comes up and keeps us from getting on the corner. And that's the fourth down
that's
play.
That's fourth down. Look at that 17 back in our backfield. I should kick the field goal there. This is where we need the clock running in. Double wing back. Complete. No, it doesn't complete it. It stops
Dale
the
Sprinkle.
Clock, though. Dale Sprinkle. Run around back there. Run around back there. Get a hold of him or something or other. Tripped him up. The clock's still running now. Dropped off a little semi-screen out there. I believe he gets out of bounds. No, that's where we got penalized. The roughness. I can grab him there. Boy, that is terrible. I just pull back, keep slipping through the middle and out of here. I stop the clock again. Here's a big, big play. He's running with the football, meaning Bond, of course, and he. And he takes a timeout because he got first down. Bingo! As of the end of the game, a great, great play for Jeremiah Castillo. Alabama 20, Mississippi State 12. And Stephen, I'm glad to have that behind us.
Yeah. Inner space. That's right. Inner space. Lower your thermostat and save money. The cold dampness of outer space can make it unlivable. Discover an amazing way to heat a room for just pennies an hour. Kerosene portable kerosene heaters. 99.9% fuel efficient, precision designed and safety tested to the highest technical standards. Kerosene brings comfort to inner space for a price that's comfortable too.
Available at Better Merchants. For your nearest dealer, see the yellow pages under heating equipment retail.
Want some gold from the end of the rainbow? Listen.
Plus or minus the square root of 4.
What's that you're studying?
Squared over 2A.
Golden Flake Cheese Curls. Best book I ever ate.
What's that you're serving?
Golden Flake Corn Chips. First chips in town good enough to serve with my curry crab dip.
For discriminating snackers all over town, Golden Flake chips and snacks are better than good. They're good as gold.
That's Coach Donahue there. Bruce Aarons is really Bruce's game. He used to be Coach Donahue's game when I asked him to put that on there. Josh Henderson, one of our captains from Panama City, Florida. Bruce Aarons is coach at Mississippi State. Mike Pitt from Baltimore, he's a senior, another one of our captains. Mike has folks in Birmingham. Jackie Klein from McCalla, another one of our captains, he's a senior. Jackie was hurt last night. I don't know how badly he is. Hope not. Very bad. Jeff Fagan, Hollywood, Florida, one of our captains. I think Jeff had the longest run of the game. We have a game we only have a 17-yard runner. Ken Coley from in Birmingham. Kenneth Coley. Kenny to me, but he's a good one. He's one of our captains. He's a senior. Joey Jones from Mobile, Alabama. And he had a great day, no doubt about that. Jesse Bendros, other wideout. He and Joey are both juniors and both are great receivers. Jay Grogan had a big, big day, I think. He's from Cropwell, Alabama, and he's a junior also. Joe Beasley from Woodbridge, Virginia. Joe was sick most of the week with a virus, but he was all right yesterday. We didn't play him much of a Norwood. Mike Hadcock, Jr. from Huntsville, Alabama. And Steve Mott, Sr. from New Orleans, Louisiana. Danny Holcomb from Marietta, Georgia. Danny's also our snapper back. He played guard and center. He played center yesterday. Snapped back for everything. Willard System from Huntsville, Alabama. He's a sophomore. Bob Kedak from Argo, Florida. Bob is a senior. Doug Vickers from Enterprise. Doug is a junior. Walter Lewis from Rootin, Alabama. He's a junior. We have some real fine juniors, thank heaven. Andy Patrick from Jasper, Alabama. He's a junior. And Ricky Moore from Huntsville, Alabama. He's a sophomore. Joe Carter from Starkville, Mississippi. He's a junior. Craig Turner from Gettysburg, Maryland. And he's a sophomore. Craig, touchdown, Craig. Russ Wood from Alba. Russ is a senior, of course. I don't mean of course, but he is. Randy Edwards from Marietta, Georgia, is a junior. Randy was held out a year due to an ailment. Tom McCrary from Scottsboro, Alabama. He's a sophomore. Tom had a big, big play. I know one. Eddie Lowe from Phoenix City. And he's a senior. Steve Brooker from Huntsville, Steve's sophomore. Emmanuel King from Leroy, and I think he had a thing. I know he had some big plays. Emmanuel's a sophomore. Tyler Wilcox from Henry, Louisiana, and he's a senior. Tyler was He injured his other ankle in the first half yesterday. I don't know how his status will be. He had a perfect score when he was hurt. Stan Gay from Tuskegee as a junior. Mike Rodriguez from Melbourne, Florida. He's also a junior. Rocky Colburn from Kenton, Florida, across the river, the state line down there. Rocky was injured yesterday, but I think he's all right. Jeremiah Castillo from King City, Alabama, who's a senior. He had that big, big play the last play of the game. Gerald Sprinkle from Hamley, Georgia. He's a senior, and Gerald is a very valuable man because he plays a half dozen, all the positions back there. Sylvester Kroon works for our linebackers. He's from Alabama. Brian Poole works for anything you ask him to. Lewis Campbell works for our secondary.
That's the freak thing about Tommy. We're so worried about one ankle, and then he hurts another ankle. A lot of times that happens.
Yeah.
When you favor, or maybe you've got maybe too much tape on one ankle, you end up hurting the other ankle. But next week's LSU, and they whipped up on Ole Miss, and they've got a great football team.
You know, I'm normally wrong about what I think, but I didn't think LSU was all that good until last night. And they really are. Going into the game, I thought Mississippi might beat them if they got hot with their passing and running together. They didn't just try to do one thing, but I listened to the game, and LSU Mississippi fumbled over and kicked off. LSU scored in first play, and then Mississippi was never in the game. They were never in the game. LSU coach got them out of there. The score might have been something awful, and they have. They had great personnel last year, but they got them organized this year. They have a great passer, really a great passer. And I think he's a real brilliant young man, too. And they have some fresh new running backs that have great speed. And their statistics are awesome, really. And, of course, the best thing they've been doing is playing defense. Nobody can score much on them. But we've been in that situation a lot. I'm looking forward to the game. I don't know whether the players are or not. I'm glad they're good. We're going to play out here at Legion Field and have a big crowd. And the LSU, one thing about them, they don't take many people with them. You don't have many tickets because they make you come to Tiger Stadium. They don't want to get you to Tiger Stadium. But they won't really will have a home field advantage or a neutral field advantage, either one you want to call it. And we're going to play in the daytime. They play better at night than they do in the daytime normally, too. I hope that still goes through. I don't know whether it'll be on TV or not. I've been asked it a lot of times, and I said I had not been contacted, but somebody told me that somebody was trying to call me Saturday. I haven't talked with them yet. Anyway, LSU is a big, big game.
Golden Flake and Carasign, see you next week.
This is Stedman Sheely inviting you to join us again next week for the Bear Bryant Show. Brought to you by Golden Flake, Alabama's own goodest gold snack. Coca-Cola, the cool refreshment, Coke is it. And your Carasign Dealer Network, we bring comfort to inner space. We urge you to continue your support of your University of Alabama.